Welcome to WebStylePress. You have to pay attention to this tutorial, otherwise you won't get it and plugin will not work for you. I shared a plugin earlier that allowed us to change permalink or add redirects for posts, pages, custom post types, tags or categories individually in WordPress. I will link that video in description. Custom Permalinks plugin serves a need to redirect URLs or customize permalinks for posts well, but that does not allow us to add redirection rule for future posts. In this video, we will solve that issue. Search and install Permalink customizer. Add new Permalink customizer. This permalink customizer is a fork of this custom permalink. Permalink customizer lets you set redirection rules for any post type to change URL structure from a single place. You don't have to go to each page or post individually to change URL or add redirect to it. If you have a custom post type, you can add a rule to customize links in that custom post type from a single page. Permalink customizer. Permalinks customizer. Okay, it has got settings. Post types, permalink settings. Then we have got Taxonomies Permalink settings. Then we have Post Types Permalinks and Taxonomies Permalinks and Redirects and Tags. Post Types Permalinks. It will list all Post Type Permalinks that were customized. And here we will have a list of all Taxonomies Permalinks that we will customize. And we have page to list all redirects in this system. And then we have got tags information. This is help page to have an idea about dynamic tags that are allowed in rewriting rules. For example, we will need this post name tag. For posts and for taxonomies, we will need this slug tag. So if you need any dynamic tags, this is the help page that will help you. You can get the tags from here to use in the areas such as here for taxonomies permalink settings or here for post types permalink settings. Okay, now we have got rules here. But first of all, let's see our site. Visit site and we have got this contact page has got about page name in the URL, and then we have got blog, we've got the post, the category, this is the post, and it has got, this is slug name and this is WordPress URL, and this is category, and it's got a name category in the URL, and we have got tags as well. This is tag page. We have got the tag word in the URL and then actual tag name. So we are going to change these URLs. Okay, so here's the page that I can use to set my rules. Okay, to test the plugin, I will add a simple additional word in the URL for posts, pages, categories, and custom post type. It can be like WSP post, WSP pages, WSP category, WSP custom post type name, and such. From post types, permalink settings, I will only customize posts, pages, products and custom post type URLs. Like I have got this custom post type, testimonials and test post type. This testimonial, this is also a custom post type that is test post type. So for the posts, I will add wsp-posts/postname. This tag is required. this is slug name. And then here, WSP, pages, and then slug name or page name. And here, WSP products, slug name. And here, WSP test. And that's it, save changes. Here we have added WSP posts in URLs for the post, and this tag name, post name, is the sanitized version of the title of the post or slug. Do not forget to include it. It is a dynamic tag for post slug. And from taxonomies permalink settings, I will just change categories and tags. Here, WSP cat. And here, for this dynamic tag, slug will be used as dynamic tag. And here, WSP tag. Again, slug will be used as dynamic tag. Save changes. Now that we have added rules for the permalink settings, let's test this. So this is our tag. Refresh the page and nothing happened. That is because the rules we applied will be applied to the new posts and new pages, but not for old ones. For posts, pages that are already in the system, we will have to update the permalink manually. This is because plugin does not want to modify every post itself. It gives you control. Maybe you don't want to change all old URLs or permalinks. So you can selectively customize old URLs and you can customize new posts automatically after creating redirect rules. After creating redirect rules, new posts will get the new permalink structure, but old posts will remain same. You can customize old posts or new posts anytime you want later on. So this is a very good option that gives us full control to change URLs individually or by defining rules. Even if you have defined redirect rules and new posts are following new URL structure, still you can go back to individual posts and customize URL structure or change redirect path manually if you need to. So what we have to do, we have to edit this tag, and here we will regenerate permalink. Okay, and the permalink was updated. Update. Now if we will refresh this page, and our link for the tag was changed and WSP tag was added here. Similarly, this is our post. We changed the URL structure, refresh it. Nothing happened. Let's edit this post. And here, we'll have to regenerate permalink. Hit OK. And it picked up the new structure, WSP posts. Update. Refresh the page. And here we have got it, WSP posts. And now let's do this with the custom post type. So this is custom post type. Let's view it. It has got old structure that has got test post type, custom post type name in the URL. We gotta change it. Edit. And here is the structure. We'll have to just regenerate permalink. Hit OK. And permalink was changed. Hit update. So this was for the old pages or posts. Refresh and the URL was changed. New word was added according to our rules, right? See WSP tag and here WSP posts and then post name, WSP pages, post name. Like we had pages as well, right? For contact. There's about in the URL. Let's edit this page. and let's click regenerate permalink. And this structure was updated. Update. And now let's view this page. And we have got this WSP pages in the URL for the page. So WSP pages, and this one is working. WSP pages and page name. So custom post types are working. And we have got products as well. We have got shop. And we have got this product. And we have got this product word in the URL. Let's edit this product. Let's regenerate permalink. Okay. And it was changed WSP products. We can update it. View product. And we have got WSP products word, custom word in the URL for this product. And even we have applied custom rule, but still we can change this URL, like here I am changing that to WebStylePress. And then hit update. URL was updated. Let's view the product. And the product picked the word WebStylePress in the URL. So it is 100% customizable. We are customizing old posts, right? So even when we have defined rules here, but for old posts, we have to click this regenerate permalink button to pick up the new URL structure for old posts. But if you want any other word or any other structure manually for this one single post or product or page or whatever it is, you can do so. Just name that word here in the URL or customize this URL in any way that you like and hit update, and this product will be updated. New URL will be here. Customized URL will be displayed. Let me close these. So this was the tag. And this is category. It has got category word here. Edit category. Here's the permalink to change. Regenerate permalink. It was updated. WSP cat update. Refresh the page. And you can see WSP dash cat here. So this is completely customizable for categories, for tags, for posts, for pages, for custom post types. But let's test one thing more. If I create new post in a custom post type, test URL, and you see, let's publish it. New post picked up new URL structure. Let's view it. And it is effective, as you can see, WSP test in the URL. And now WSP, if I use WSP posts, update, WSP posts. So this plugin is 100% flexible and customizable. So we have got post types permalink settings and taxonomy permalink settings, rules that you can define here. And then we've got post types permalinks. Let's refresh this page. These are the rules that we have defined. We have defined a rule for this, for these two posts, custom post types. And this is a post and product. it was the page. So post types permalinks listed here that we customized. And then for taxonomies, we edited these taxonomies and we customized URL for these or added redirects. And redirects, all redirects are here. You can remove any single one. You can remove all of these if you want to revert back changes for all of your site. So I like this plugin and it's a must have. Full control over URL structure and permalink settings for WordPress site that saves you a lot of time and helps you manually add redirects or helps you define rules to change permalink structure for any post type. And these redirects are search engine safe. Redirection is being done with 301 status code. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.